show you the advantage of the second display on the 34410 and 34411 Agilent DMMs. First, let's move to the whiteboard. I'd like to show you a real typical situation when measuring voltage. On the whiteboard, we have a simple XY graph. On the X-axis, we have time, and on the Y-axis, voltage. When we use a DMM, we're typically looking to either measure a DC voltage, where it's constant over time, or an AC voltage, where it may be cycling, and we're looking at the value from high to low, or the RMS value. With the second display on the 34410 and 11 DMMs, you actually get to look at both components, the DC value, and then any AC or potential noise that may be on your DC value. I'm going to set up a function generator to output a signal. The DC offset component will be 2.5 volts. But the AC component will be 500 millivolts peak to peak. In most situations with voltmeters, you'd only be able to see one of these at a time, but with the second display for the 34410 and 11, I'll show you how we can look at both of these parameters at the same time. Now let's move to our setup, and I'll show you how to make this measurement. In our setup, we have a Agilent 33250 function generator and an Agilent 34410A DMM. I'm just going to simply connect the output of the function generator to the input of the DMM with this coax cable and banana plug. I'm going to zoom in now on the function generator so you can see how I set up the waveform we previously described. To adjust the function generator, there's three things that we need to do. First, we need to make sure that the output is set for a high input impedance because our DMM has a high input impedance. So we use the utility menu, and then we select the output setup soft key. You can see the default is for a 50 ohm impedance situation, but we do have a high Z or high impedance load, so we'll change that and select done. The second thing we want to do is set the amplitude. And remember, we're going to set an amplitude of 500 millivolts. So we've got 500 millivolts peak to peak. Finally, we want an offset of 2.5 volts. So we have 2.5 volts DC offset with a 500 millivolt peak-to-peak sine wave on top of that signal. The last thing we will do is set the output to on, and now the 33250 is outputting this signal. Let's take a look at the DMM and see how this second display works. Now we are looking at the display of the 34410A, and we've just powered it on. And you can see the default is to measure DC voltage, and we are measuring approximately that 2.5 volts offset that we set up on the function generator. You can see the noise that's rattling around, but we really don't have a good idea what that is. And this is the value of the second display for the 34410. So let me go ahead and turn on that second display. You can see we have a choice of turning it off or, for DC volts, looking at the peak-to-peak value. So I'm going to choose the peak-to-peak value and hit enter. Now we can see both the DC voltage at 2.5 volts and we can see the peak-to-peak voltage that's riding on top of that being 500 millivolts. If we scroll to the right on the second display, it also shows us the peak, max, and min values, which are approximately 2.5 volts each. So the advantage of the 34410 and 11 DMMs is not only can we look at the DC content, we can see what the AC content is and see them at the same time. So this concludes a short video showing you how to use the second display to provide an additional parameter when measuring a voltage.